Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. In today's review video, I'll be talking about Infamous Second Son, a PS4 exclusive, so if you haven't heard of it, maybe that's why. One thing before we start off this video, of course there's spoilers ahead, but also I want to give out a trigger warning. If you can't deal with flashing lights, please don't watch this video. It will have a lot of flashing lights because the powers that you're getting in Infamous are really bright. And it might mess you up a little bit, so be warned of that. And of course, like I said, there's spoilers ahead, so if you haven't played this game but still want to, spoiler free. I just suggest not watching this video. I will also be talking a little bit about the first and the first two Infamous games. So in general, maybe if you don't want the spoilers, well, don't watch this video. Infamous Second Son is set 7 years after the second game. You're now playing as Delson Rowe, a little Akomish delinquent. Who likes to vandalize billboards and spray paint over everything. He has been arrested multiple times by his own brother, Reggie Rowe, and this is exactly what happens again. You're basically starting the game off spray painting a billboard of Reggie, and as you are about to leave, you hear cops incoming sirens, and you flee into the fish factory. Now, before you can really leave, Betty comes in. A little old Akomish woman, and she's holding a stapler, ready to staple you, basically, to death. She comes in, gives you a free pass to leave, but Reggie still catches you, and as you guys are discussing, you know, terms and how life is going for Delson, a DUP van crashes right in front of them. This DUP van was supposed to bring three prisoners to Curtin K, a prison for, well, designed for conduits, aka bioterrorists, as the DUP claims them. And, well, the bioterrorists, aka, well, we just call them conduits, they escape. Now, one of them is having some trouble getting out, and you guys are helping him. But as he, Hank, or, well, Henry Daughtry, as he sees Reggie is a cop, he starts to panic and basically grabs Delson hostage. Which, of course, is never a good idea. As he has Delson hostage, he gathers smoke from the car that just crashed, basically, that he was just in. And he fires a fireball at Reggie. Delson, however, panics and he grabs his hand. With this, you gain a little bit of Henry's, or well, Hank. You gain some of his memories and, more importantly, his powers. As you now have smoke powers, you basically follow Hank through the fish factory, which he set on fire to cut, you know, he wanted to make a distraction. You're battling basically with Hank for maybe a few minutes, trying to learn some tricks from him, but he is not having it because obviously she is coming. Now you might think, who is she? She is Brooke Augustine, the leader, the boss of the DUP, and she has concrete powers. And you meet her very fast. When you leave the fish cuttery, you basically are surrounded by DUP. Well, agents, I guess. And Augustine is leading the troops. She makes Hank into a little concrete statue, kind of imprisons him on her own. And you guys start talking. Now, of course, Delson is a little bit nervous. Because he just got his powers and he doesn't know even to control them yet. Augustine, she mentions this and Delson claims he is not nervous at all. After a bit of a, well, really cheesy line that he gets nervous around pretty girls. She kind of leaves him alone, but then when he mentions that she is a conduit as well, she turns around, says he is after all confident, and, well, she uses her concrete powers to grow spikes into Delson's leg, trying to make him talk. Now, this is also the first chance you get to choose a path. You can choose between evil and good karma. Good karma basically leads to you talking. You're telling Augustine you just got your powers, and she doesn't believe you, obviously, but, you know, she hurts Betty with the same trick she does with you, and, you know, it's not good. If you choose evil karma, however, you basically do not talk, and Betty doesn't talk, no one talks, and they all still end up pretty hurt. Just the same way they will when you choose good karma. But this is basically your path that you choose. This is really famous for the Infamous games. You can choose between good and evil. And, well, good basically gets you different powers. Evil gets you different powers. It's just, you know, it gives you different moves. It's really cool. Now it turns out these spikes actually don't disappear on their own, and these people are dying now. Now you, as Dalsun, you have these powers, so you basically heal on your own. They disappeared. So together, you decide to go to Seattle and confront Brooke Augustine to grab her concrete powers. It's a little bit of an easy plan, to be honest, and it doesn't work out the way they want. But in Seattle, you basically get in a lot of trouble with the DUP. You have to destroy some outposts. You have to do some stuff. But most importantly, you meet some new Conduits. Now, as I said before, three Conduits escaped into the crash. Now, without going too much into the story, you meet the second Conduit pretty fast after you come in Seattle. The second Conduit is Abigail Fetch Walker. But we just call her Fetch, right? She's really nice. However, she was addicted to drugs and killed her brother in the process. Now, of course, she felt really bad about that, and she has been imprisoned in the Curtin Case since then. After a big discussion, big fight, you gather her powers, which are neon. And well, she's kind of teaching you how to use it, which is really nice. And she kind of becomes Dalsun's girlfriend. After a few missions, including taking care of the Space Needle's communication, yes, we go and climb on the Space Needle. You basically meet the last conduit from the crash, which is Eugene Sims. After a while, basically he just contacts you out of the blue, and you think it's just a fan. However, he has one of my favorite powers, a video, and he's the last conduit you want to face. Eventually, you gotta find out Eugene has been bullied before, and at one point he just snaps, and he summons these demons, which he made up in his mind because of this video game he plays, and they basically, it was not good. So anyway, you meet those two new conduits, you gather both these powers. Like I said, video was by far my favorite. Now Hank calls out of the blue, and this is actually just a trick from Augustine. She wants to trick you into being imprisoned, and it almost works. However, Reggie comes in with the clutch and rocket launches her fucking ass. As Reggie does this, Dalsun has now troubles, and it basically all leads up to the fact that Reggie gets blasted off the platform. Now you are basically with him there, you hold his hand, but it is no use. His concrete stone form basically takes over, and he realizes it's time to let go. He tells Dalsun he's proud of him, and he basically lets go of his hand, falling to his death, and Dalsun is left there to grieve. After this, you basically battle Augustine, and if in it starts off pretty great. You know, you have neon, you have smoke, you have video, but eventually you gather concrete powers. Now, with Fetch and, you know, Eugene, you had these core relays that basically give you powers. They helped you with that. You gather concrete in the battle, and you basically have to dodge. You have to duck. You have to hide. Because Eugene provides you with core relays, but you have to grab it, like, after a few minutes. So it's not instantly, so you don't get powers instantly. Now, of course, you beat Augustine. Throughout your progress, you basically stayed on the path. In the beginning, you chose between good and evil karma. That basically continues until the whole story. Now, you can swap at any moment, but it's hard. I'm not gonna lie. So, depending on what you chose as evil or good karma, basically you get a good or evil ending. You can decide to kill off Augustine, basically the evil karma, which basically leads you to be a badass. Everyone is terrified of you. And most importantly, you basically shake everyone's hand, you know, gather new powers. That is at least the plan. Now, after you end the game, you will notice that you do not have new powers. I was a little bit disappointed, not gonna lie. Or you choose the good, you know, the good karma, and that is basically spare Augustine but imprison her. You show off who she really was, what the DUP really was, and people will see you as a hero. And you. Well, the last scene, basically, I totally forgot about the evil karma, but if you do the evil karma, the last scene is basically Betty rejecting you, basically sending you away from the Komish, and you destroy the whole place, basically killing everyone in sight. And this is all because of what you did in Seattle, of course. If you choose the good karma, however, like I said, you spare Augustine, But more importantly, you go home, they welcome you back, and you are painting a tribute to Reggie, which I thought was really nice. Now, I quickly went over what everything, over the story. Of course, it is a much more to this than it is. You hook up with Fetch, you talk with Eugene about girls and like stuff like that. You get along with all these characters, and it is such an amazing feeling. But to be sure with it, yes, this is the story. Now, for me, Infamous Second Son was a crazy good game. It was one of the first PS4 games I had. It is actually an older PS4 game as well. It kind of came out of the blue, to be honest to me. I never heard of this game series before, so Infamous Second Son was perfect for me because it did not focus on the first two games at all. It gives you a little description of the DOP right before you start. Explaining that the DOP van is heading out and that van will never arrive at Gordon Gay. That's basically the start of the game. Cole McGrath is not even mentioned, which I think maybe in a way is maybe a little bit bad. Now, Infamous Second Son came kind of as a surprise to me. I did not know this game was gonna be out anytime soon. This game basically came out right after the PS4 was released. It was not long after. It was a PS4 exclusive as well. It did not even release on the PS3, which I kind of understand. But the most important pro for me was that it didn't even focus on the first two stories. It focused entirely on a different story, which is good because if you have never heard of Infamous or even played the games, it makes kind of sense. If they decided to continue the story of Cole McGrath, I think I would have absolutely not have known anything. It even gives you a little description of the DUP of how it was formed and stuff like that, right as you right as you start. Second pro is definitely cool powers. I need to admit that smoke is my least favorite power, and you start off with that. But that's because Neon gets so much more advanced, and then you get video, which is even crazier. With smoke, you kinda can go through vents. You get vent healing if you have good karma. You have some other stuff as well if you have bad karma. Like I said, it basically depends on what you choose. But good karma basically has to subdue enemies. Good karma literally kills them off, rips their heads off. It's really cool. It's really nice. You get different powers. Moves more. But I need to admit, Neon was also not really entirely my favorite. Well, Neon was pretty cool. You could run up walls and like do crazy shit. I think video definitely beats it for me. I mean, you get all these, like I said, demons and angels that Eugene used. Well, you get those too. Now with good karma, I think you get angels. With bad karma, you get demons. But you can basically summon them to fight with you, and I think that is crazy good. Also, my opinion, I know that a lot of people might not think of it the same way, but Delson Roe was such a fun character as well. He had character, he had a personality. He thought life was a joke until Reggie died. Then he took it a little bit more serious. Like he was supposed to be this delinquent, and suddenly he is a hero. It was such a crazy good story in general, and having a character that is actually fun and optimistic, but also kind of sees things as they are, I think that is really cool. They did a really good job on Delson Roe, I think. Yeah. Now, one of the cons, however, was that the game can be a little bit glitchy sometimes. I had Delson, for example, stand through a table. There was people suddenly kind of glitched out. There was a little few glitches, but honestly it wasn't game breaking. I was still able to do missions. It's just sometimes it's a little bit funny, in certain games you have glitches where the game is actually breaking because of them. Cyberpunk. This game, however, it doesn't break anything, so honestly it's just all right. And one con I have written down here is that the game is a little bit easy to beat. I played this game maybe 7 or 8 times, and I beat it almost every single time. The truth is, when you get the hang of the powers, when you get the hang of everything, it's really easy to beat everything. I think this is the first game I actually platinumed at PS4, or maybe even the only game, actually, now I'm thinking of it. The game is really easy to beat, but that, well, I have it written as a con, but it's not even necessarily a con. Because when you beat the game, it's just so much more rewarding, you know? Because you have a lot of things to do before you beat the game, and that is exactly what makes it so much more fun. But yeah, if you are looking for a hard game to beat, I think, well, I would still say experience it for yourself, but it is easy to beat, all right? Now, my overall review for Infamous Second Son is maybe a little bit biased because I absolutely love the game. Absolutely. However, I will say, like, with the little glitches and how easy it is to beat, I would say maybe I would give the game maybe a 7.5/8. Now, it really depends on how you see it because I know a lot of people wish that it was Cole McGrath. I know a lot of people don't think Delson was actually that great as of a character. And I totally understand. It's not for everyone. You have to have a sort of sense of humor, I guess, to really love this game. But on the same side, I just think you have to give it a try if you can. If you have a PS4, I definitely recommend this game. Yes, I do. It looks fantastic. It plays amazingly smooth. And it is one of the first games that basically use the touchpad as a map. Now, I think that is really cool. All right, it was a super awesome game, really fun to play, and I think everyone should, you know, have the chance to experience it. I think it's even on sale right now. If you can, experience it. If you cannot, well, I'm sorry. But I hope this review helped, you know, see a point of view of the game. And yeah, like I said, 7.5 slash 8 maybe. But yeah, that depends a little bit on glitches, really. But yeah. That was my review video of Infamous Second Son. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you guys have a view of how this game is like. I'm sorry for any random noises you heard throughout this video. I somehow touched a little bag and some other stuff while recording this. I don't know if it recorded with it, but we'll see. Next review video is gonna be up this month as well, and this is a banger, I'm gonna tell you, because the next review video will be The Last of Us. Which will be the first game, you know, not the second one. And then I'm planning on doing the second one actually kind of right after it as well. Maybe the same week, if we can. We'll see. But yeah, hope you guys enjoyed. Hope to see you guys in the next video. And with that, yeah. Have a nice day, nice night, wherever you are. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye, guys.